All right, here's this 4G63 six bolt we're doing for a customer. This is getting an aluminum rotted wet block deal, so it's gonna in with an MLS, so it's gonna get a low protrusion O-ring in the deck. But so I'd run through the whole process with you on this thing. Yeah, so first thing we got to do, this is how it came to me. We're gonna pull the dowels out of the deck surface real fast, and then pull the oil squirters out of it. The main bearings are still in it. I gotta pull those all out, basically strip the block, and we're gonna stick it in the hot tank to get it kind of cleaned up before we machine it. So after I get it out of the hot tank, then we'll stick it on the decking machine, deck it, and run through the torque plate honing and boring process, that kind of thing. So yeah, check it out. Alright, I wanted to show you guys what the difference is from the different cleaning processes, right? So here's this is just a 7-bolt block, obviously hasn't been cleaned, still covered in oil, that kind of thing. This is that 6-bolt block we just talked about, out of the hot tank. So you can tell that obviously all the oil's gone. This thing has got some stuff built up still, like you can see this kind of sludge stuff in there. I'll take care of that in our mineral spirits tank, in the solvent tank. This is what a baked and blasted block looks like. Like I said, it basically comes back looking brand new. So yeah, you'll notice that the girdle doesn't look as new as the block. That's because we don't typically blast the girdle. The girdle just gets hot tanked, and then the block itself gets baked and blasted. So. But yeah, that's pretty much the difference between those three. This 6-bolt block we're working on has a couple issues I want to address before we start machining it. There's a lot of casting flash, both in the oil passages in the front of the block, and we machine that step, or well, I'll port that step down a little bit. If you're familiar with the 6-bolts at all, you'll see how that's got a ledge right before it goes into the, try to give you an image of it, into the main oil galley there. Here's a 7-bolt block for reference. See how the edge is gone. I'm not gonna pull it out completely, but we'll bring it down a little bit and just round the edges so oil has a better passage into the main galley. And then I'm gonna deburr a few things here, just a few of the ridges on top of the, just the main bearing support stuff that's cast into this. There's a lot of flash in a couple, in there, see all that. So I'm gonna spend some time cleaning up that stuff before we get on the machine work side of things. I'm gonna lay the block down and get these other two out of the way and get going on that. So I thought I'd show you real quick before I get cutting on this thing what I'm gonna use for tooling. Obviously this is the same die grinder I use for my port work stuff. Some of the similar burrs. I'm gonna use this one for the bulk removal. This stuff here on the tops of the main supports. And then to get down in the stuff, I'm gonna use the olive shaped burr. This is a serrated burr meant for like ferrous materials. And then when I do the oil galley, I'm gonna use a combination of this guy to do the corner work and the olive shaped one. And then obviously a sand roll to finish the oil galley stuff here. The stuff in the block, I'll leave rough. As far as with the olive burr, I'm just trying to knock the majority of the stuff off of here to prevent problems later down the road, you know? So I'm gonna jump into it. Okay, so I got it. You can see where I cut all the casting flash stuff off of it. And the oil galley stuff. So the next step we're going to do is I'm going to grab some, actually just some like normal, I have it right here, some SOS pad. And I'm going to clean these surfaces up. I'm just going to start doing that, I guess. So the reason I do this is just to pull up any corrosion that's built up on this, just basically to clean any small spots of it off. When I deck it, it's the bar sits here, and the purpose of that bar is to ensure that the deck is square to the crankshaft centerline. Obviously, if there's debris, you know, if there's anything in here built up in there or on any of these, it makes that reading inaccurate. Now, when I'm indicating the block in on the machine, I can obviously see if there's any imperfections there or anything that just doesn't add up, right? Doesn't make any sense. But this is just a step I've always taken. We'll just make sure there's nothing odd here. We'll do the block side and the cap side of it. And then we'll put the caps on here and we'll torque the caps as they're intended to be. These stock bolts, I usually just torque these things like 55 foot pounds and with some assembly oil on them. And that's all we're gonna do. So I'm gonna clean the cap side up real fast. Now the cap side obviously isn't important because it's on the bottom side of that bar, but it's always good to just be thorough, I suppose, even if it's a little unnecessary. So, yeah, I'm gonna clean these all up and get the caps on there and torqued, and then we'll be ready to go through the machining process with this. First step we're gonna do is deck it, and then, yeah, and then we'll get it bored and the O-ring put in it, so. So now, getting a little bit of this water pump gasket left over on it that's still on. Now this thing is, the mains are all torqued. Everything's been cleaned up. It's ready to get decked now. I say cleaned up, I mean just hot tanked, obviously. But yeah, it's ready to go on the decking machine. We'll cut the deck surface. We'll bore it. We'll get the O-ring groove cut in it, put the O-rings in it so we can simulate the how the top of the bore is deformed with the torque plate on it. I just made posted a previous video that shows just with a head gasket in it and how much it deforms the top of the cylinder. It actually moved the top of the cylinder 0.7 of a thou between the torque plate on it and the torque plate off of it just with a head gasket. So imagine the deformation caused by pushing on an O-ring. So this is gonna get a low protrusion O-ring because it's gonna have an MLS gasket still, which basically means the O-ring is gonna be a 3 to 5 thou protrusion. But even that little bit's gonna have a significant effect on the deformation on top of the cylinder when the head is torqued on it with the torque plate. So so that's pretty much it for this video. This shows you the hot tank process, the difference in the cleaning stuff, some of the block prep we do as far as the casting flash, cleaning the oil galleys up, and just everything we do pre-starting the machine operations. Obviously that varies a little bit from engine to engine. Another thing we'll do if we're gonna get it baked and blasted is we'll have all the oil galley plugs, the freeze plugs out of it, the oil galley plug out of the back of it. We'll pop the balance shaft bearings out of it when we send it out to get baked and blasted. So it's another step that needs to happen as well in that process. In this process, I'll still pop these bearings out and pull the oil galley plug out. But I'll do that after the machine work is completed, just to make sure we can thoroughly clean all the oil passages. The freeze plugs will stay in place. But yeah, that's it for this one. I'm gonna get this thing on a decking machine, get it machined up, and keep moving forward with it. So subscribe to check out our other videos, and I'm gonna keep producing these things. So if there's anything you guys wanna see, leave a comment or shoot us an email at our shop page or hit up our Facebook page, whichever, and I'll see if I can put a video together for you. So thanks for watching.